Emma's ruthless. 2 weeks after U.S. Open glory, Raducanu axes her coach. Fairy tales do not last long in sport, and for Andrew Richardson that meant being dumped this week as Emma Raducanu's coach. Before details, don't forget to subscribe and press bell icon for more videos. The former British Davis Cup player, who emerged from relative obscurity to guide Raducanu through her triumphant American Odyssey, has already found himself surplus to requirements as the 18-year-old plans her next move. Just as Nigel Sears was ruthlessly disposed of after her breakthrough at Wimbledon, Richardson is seeking alternative employment despite their dramatically successful pairing of the last 2 months. Raducanu explained she was looking for someone with more high-level tour experience. Earlier, at a homecoming event laid on at Roehampton's National Tennis Center, she had described the U.S. Open afterparty with her close-knit team as her single most joyous memory. Yet nothing would cloud the judgment of her and her father Ian that someone else is needed for the next step. "I just realized I really need someone right now who has had the experience at the high levels, which mean that I'm looking for someone who has been at that level and knows what it takes," she said, admitting parting had not been easy. "It's tough to have that conversation with anyone, but I think for me that's just really what I need. The players at the top, they're serious competition, so I feel like I just really need someone who can really guide me along the way because I'm still very new to everything." Richardson was said not to have been at Roehampton on Thursday when she returned to training, and she worked instead with LTA coach Matt James. Raducanu's physio Will Herbert, one of the tiny group around her in New York, appears likely to be retained. There will be no shortage of options for her to look at among those who have coached Grand Slam champions Darren Cahill. The Australian, who has just finished with Simona Halep, is one. Those with close links to her management company, IMG, include people who have worked with Maria Sharapova, such as Dutchman Sven Groeneveld and Swede Thomas Hogstedt. Carlos Rodriguez, the Argentine who worked with Justine Henin, is another. Raducanu said yesterday that she had yet to decide whether to ask for a wild card into the Indian Wells tournament early next month, and would make the choice in the coming days. She is entered in Moscow's Kremlin Cup, which follows, but added, "I don't want to rush in, I haven't had that much time to rest up. My priority is just putting in the best possible preseason so that I can start strong next year." Potentially qualifying for the 8-woman WTA finals, which is now feasible, would purely be a bonus, she said. Raducanu and fellow British U.S. Open champions Joe Salisbury, Alfie Hewitt and Gordon Reid had an ecstatic welcome back from an assembled crowd of invited schoolchildren. Asked about her education, she said she would be interested in doing a degree in economics at some point. She was given a taste of more awkward questions when asked for her position on vaccine uptake among athletes. She replied that, "It's a personal choice, I guess, really, because everyone has their own thoughts on the vaccine." Later a clarification was issued, stating she herself has been double jabbed. Andy Murray's promising run at the Moselle Open and Mets ended with a quarterfinal loss to top seed Hubert Hurkacz. Victories over Hugo Humbert and Vasek Pospisil had seen the Scot reached the last eight at an ATP Tour event for the first time since October 2019. Hurkacz, who defeated Roger Federer to reach the Wimbledon semifinals in July, won 7-6, 6-3. Murray is due to play in the San Diego Open next week. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe and press bell icon for more videos.